The Samsung Galaxy Note 10 series smartphones is here and it comes in two variants, the Galaxy Note 10 and the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Hey guys, I'm Jam of JamOnline.ph and welcome back to my channel, and today we're gonna talk about the latest flagship smartphones from Samsung, the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 and the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. First, let's talk about the display of these two smartphones. So both of these smartphones pack an Infinity O display with a punch hole in the middle of the display of the smartphone, and the Galaxy Note 10 comes in a smaller 6.3 inch Full HD Plus display, while the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus comes with a massive 6.8 inch display with a better resolution. In my usage, I definitely love the sharper and crisper display of the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus. But don't worry about the display of the Samsung Galaxy Note 10, because despite having a smaller resolution, the colors are still good, and yes, it is still quite crisp, but not as crisp as the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. Once you hold the smartphone, you'll immediately feel that it's a Samsung Galaxy Note smartphone. Compared to the Galaxy S series, the Galaxy Note series feels more blocky, and yet these two smartphones in the Galaxy Note series are very ergonomic and it has a symmetrical design which fits perfectly in my hand. So whether you get the Galaxy Note 10 or the Galaxy Note 10 Plus with a bigger display, you still get that symmetrical and a perfect fit to your hand, body, and construction. And despite using premium materials on both the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus, both of these smartphones feel light when you hold it. The Galaxy Note 10 is actually the slimmest and lightest Galaxy Note that we have ever seen. Samsung has also improved their Samsung DeX and synchronization with PC and Macintosh, as Samsung has partnered with Microsoft to better sync your messages, notifications, phone calls, and almost everything to your PC. Not just that, there's also support for drag and drop, so you could easily transfer your files from your PC to your smartphone. Performance is something that Samsung is really serious about on the Galaxy Note 10 series. So inside these smartphones is a brand new 7-nanometer Exynos 9825 processor. Samsung promises that we'll see a 33% better performance on the CPU and 42% better performance on the GPU compared to the Galaxy Note 9. And thanks to that 7-nanometer processor, we do have a faster AI on this smartphone. We're also seeing an up to 12 gigs of RAM, but in the Philippines, we'll be getting the 8 gigs with 128 gigs internal storage on the Note 10, while the Note 10 Plus comes with a 12 gigs RAM with a 256 gigs of internal storage or a 512 gigs of internal storage. Inside the Galaxy Note 10 is a 3,500 mAh of battery, while the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus comes with a 4,300 mAh of battery. But since we're getting a smooth footprint and dimensions on the Galaxy Note 10, it's not surprising that we're only getting a 3,500 mAh of battery on the Note 10. Well, if you're worried about the battery, well, the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 series comes with a super fast charging. It means that both of these smartphones now support 45 watts super fast charging, and you could actually use the smartphone for a whole day with just 30 minutes of charging. Samsung has also added the world's slimmest vapor chamber cooling system on the smartphone, and it will bring a better gaming experience on the smartphone, and of course a better temperature when playing games. Actually, a vapor chamber cooling system is a great deal for smartphone gamers when they're playing and they're using LTE or 5G. So yeah, it's a big help for gamers. There's also another feature called the Play Galaxy Link P2P. So this feature lets you stream your games on your PC or gaming notebook directly to your Samsung Galaxy Note 10. So you can play your PC games on your smartphone by just streaming it. So the Play Galaxy Link P2P streaming service is a really cool feature, especially for PC gamers, as you can play your PC games directly to your smartphone via streaming. So this one works similarly to Steam Link on your PC. One of the biggest updates done on the Samsung Galaxy Note 10's S Pen is the unibody design. and of course, the addition of Air Action. So this feature let us use the smartphone's S Pen work like a Wiimote. Air Action lets you navigate the camera of the smartphone, the music player, and in the future, Samsung has promised that they'll be adding an SDK for third-party developers. This is actually a great opportunity for developers to create games that work similarly to Wii games. And hopefully, games like Just Dance will reach to the Galaxy Note 10's S Pen. I think it's a great feature. I think it has a great development in the future that we might see in applications and also some games. Actually, Samsung has also added new features on the camera of the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus, and it's called the AR Doodle. So this feature lets you doodle on your face or any object, then record it so you can share it online. This is a cool feature, and you could clearly see that AI works perfectly on the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. We're using the engineering unit of the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. And it's still an engineering unit, so the software is not yet final, the hardware is not yet final, but the Air Action works. Sometimes it's a little bit flaky, but the fact that I can use it like a Wiimote is a great opportunity for developers to create apps and games for the S Pen. Another cool feature on the Galaxy Note 10's S Pen is the ability to convert your handwriting to text. You can jot down notes, write something on the S Notes, and directly convert it to text, so you could copy and paste it to your Keep Notes, to your grocery list, or just paste it and send it to anyone on Messenger. Not just that, you could actually convert these texts to Microsoft Word directly from the Samsung Notes application. The camera of the smartphone has been upgraded too, especially on the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. So the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 comes with a triple lens camera at the back, 12 megapixel wide angle lens, 16 megapixel ultra wide, and a 12 megapixel telephoto lens, while the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 Plus features the same camera setup with an addition of a VGA depth vision camera for better depth sensing. The depth sensing is very applicable to features like the live focus video that I'm gonna show you later. Again, the unit that we're using is an engineering unit, so the quality or the software of this one might not be final. So this one will be different from the consumer unit. But overall, I got a good shots, a really cool live focus video on the Samsung Galaxy Note 10, and especially on the Note 10 Plus, on both the rear and front camera of the smartphone. The live focus video works. However, it's still a little bit flaky. It's not perfect, but it works. Actually, I'm gonna show you some of the shots that we took using the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 series smartphones. Aside from that, Samsung has also added another feature which is great for videographers. It's called the Zoom In Mic. So it lets you better amplify and capture the audio that you are shooting with your Samsung Galaxy Note 10. Of course, we still have the features like the IP68 certification, the ultrasonic fingerprint scanner, the wireless power share, and a lot more. However, with all these new features announced for the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus, there are some things that are now missing on the Galaxy Note 10 series. So first, we do not have a micro SD card slot on the Galaxy Note 10, but don't worry, there's a 256 gigs of internal storage, which is more than enough for most people. And the Galaxy Note 10 Plus comes with a micro SD card slot. So if you want the micro SD card slot, go for the Note 10 Plus. Second, the Bixby button is now missing, and the power button works as the Bixby button by just tapping it twice. The placement feels odd to me though, as the Bixby button was originally placed at the power button of the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus, but it's quite ergonomic when you're using the ultrasonic fingerprint scanner of the Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. Lastly, Samsung has finally joined the dark side by ditching the 3.5mm headphone jack on the Galaxy Note 10 and the Galaxy Note 10 Plus. So if you want to use your 3.5mm audio jack, speaker, headphones, or whatever that is, you need to buy a dongle, as the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus will come with a wired USB-C headphones out of the box. Overall, the Samsung Galaxy Note 10 series is more than a refined Samsung Galaxy S series, as we got a better processor with a vapor cooling chamber, which is a big deal for gamers, a better AR thanks to the depth sensing camera, and of course, we now have an AR Doodle, which is a great application for AR. The camera has also been upgraded, and of course, we now have two screen sizes which will definitely cater the people who wants to have a Note series but wants to have a smaller footprint or smaller dimension device, or someone who wants a more massive, more immersive device with a better performance. So if you want a better performance, go for the Note 10 Plus. But if you just want a Note device that you can use, just take notes, jot down notes, or just want the features of the Galaxy Note 10, just go for the regular Galaxy Note 10. Both devices are still great, by the way, despite the lack of the quadruple lens on the Galaxy Note 10 and the lack of micro SD card slot. I mean, the depth sensing camera of the Galaxy Note 10 Plus is a great addition. However, the camera of the Note 10 is still great for me. So yeah, I guess that's it for our video about the Galaxy Note 10 and the Note 10 Plus. So don't forget to check out my social media accounts. You can check out the links below at the description. So if you like this video, don't forget to give us a thumbs up. And if you haven't subscribed to my channel yet, well, now is the time to subscribe. So once again, I am Jam of JamOnline.ph, and see you guys again on my next video.